few days ago, while I was testing the super strong magnets for the hemispherical flex LED prototype, I noticed something weird going on with the silicone wires. The magnetic field was literally forcing them to move and vibrate around. This kind of blew my mind. Don't get me wrong, any wire carrying a current should create a magnetic field, which is basic physics. But this wire was only carrying a 200 milliamp 5 watt signal and wasn't looped in a coil. So today I want to use these magnets and dive deeper into this experiment and hopefully build something beautiful. The silicone wire I'm using is 30 gauge, which means that it can roughly handle 1.2 amps. To power it, I'm going to use this custom driver. This has a PIC16F microcontroller that generates a signal to control an H-bridge module. Both the frequency and duty cycle can be controlled based on the value of the potentiometer and the mode it's in. It should handle at least 1.8 amps, so for this project it's going to be more than enough. I will talk about this PCB in more detail in the future, but for now we need to create a super long resistor. The total resistance of the wire currently measures 5.5 ohms. So I'm going to start cutting the wire until we reach the target, which is 4.2 ohms. The wire is now trimmed. I have also 3D printed this new magnet holder that has these slots over here so that the wire can pass through them. I'm first going to test a one wire test. Remember that both of these magnets are facing different polarities, so using the right hand rule you should know that the wire is going to form a sine wave shape. So let's power it on. That is our sine wave. And now if we switch the signal, the wire is jumping. The next step is going to be to tighten this. I have no idea how this is going to perform. It could either be a success or a complete tied up mess. That is super weird. I have created a monster. To make it more powerful, I decided to bring the wires closer to the magnets, which made it way louder. The pulsed current was lower than 1.2 amps, so I decided to cut some extra wire to unleash the full power. I'm not sure what's the exact purpose of this, but it looks super cool. And it didn't get all tangled up. So if you enjoyed watching this one day build, please leave a like and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.